Well, as you can see, still loads to do here. I've got the new earth turning up to level this off on Saturday. And I've also bought the seed and the fertilizer and the seed laying tool. It's about that big, little trolley thing. I'll show you that in a minute. But I've also got other projects on the goes because I've got other channels as well. You might see that there's a strip there of earth which looks like it's been rotivated or cultivated. Well, I can't show you how to do that in this video, how I did that, but you'll have to watch my retro restore video out on the 30th of June, which is tomorrow if you're watching this on the day, and you'll see how I managed to cultivate or rotivate that little strip there. That was a test strip. It'll be rotivated at the end of the week before the new earth goes down. See you in a minute. Ah, right, well, let me put this over there, hold on. Well, I've been having a bit of a clear up. The workshop up until yesterday was very, very mucky. And this table here, this thing I found on Facebook Marketplace last week or the week before, has turned out to be an invaluable tool, and it's a good quality one as well. It's not one of the cheaper ones. This one probably cost hundreds and hundreds of pounds, and it's worth its weight in gold, that's all I can say. So thinking about getting a table lift, this is really a good tool to have, and it's extended my workshop counter there, and now I've got this here as well, and it's ideal for facing towards the camera. So yeah, that's that. So I've been busy working on the rotivator. You're gonna see that tomorrow, coming out tomorrow, the video tomorrow. Not all went to plan. A lot of you said that the carburetor shouldn't pour out fuel like that. Well, I obviously knew that anyway. And what I did do, which I didn't show you on camera, was afterwards I took the float, because it had that float that looked like a fishing float, basically, with a pin at the top and a pin at the bottom. And the pin looked like it was bent, the brass pin. So I took the float out of the other one, put that on. That did improve things, but the rotivator still had terrible problems trying to start. So I did strip it down. You'll see that in tomorrow's video. It's already done, the video, so you'll see exactly what happened in that on my retro restore channel. So make sure you do check that video out. You'll be surprised. A lot of people saying, oh, the carb is flooding, it needs adjusting. Well, I'm not stupid at the end of the day. I know what needs to be done, and I'll show you the procedure I went through to find the possible problem of that rotivator. Anyway, that's enough of that. As I've got quite a few things on at the moment, that means I've got quite a little few little things outstanding to do. I've still got a retro hacks video to do. I'm struggling with getting stuff and parts for some things which I'm waiting for. I've got some Tonka trucks to restore, but I like to spread them sort of things out, because if you put too much of one thing on, people get fed up with it. So I'm trying to spread stuff out, and I've got some other things which I'm working on at the moment. And yeah, the garden is waiting for the grass seed and the earth to come. So I'm got to tinker about and get stuff cleared out there. I've been out the front, let's show you out the front. This is the second skip, as you know, which I've filled up. These bits of trees and stuff in there was the stuff that was laying outside the front of the drive, where I had to cut the side fence down to my property and gain access there. So all that wood now has had to be cut up and put in there, which I've done that this morning. So again, these are the little jobs which you don't see behind the scene, which have to get done to make a job continue to go down the pathway. One other thing I'm gonna do is I've put that gate back up over there. This one here, this used to be about 15 or 20 foot further back, and Jimmy pulled it off its hinges, as you probably know, which I said in the last video, but I've put it up right at the front there. So what I'm gonna do, now it's up and it's fitted, I'm gonna give it a coat of just a wood treatment, just to bring it back to life, so to speak. All this drive will eventually have to get done. And yeah, so I mean, it's little jobs like this that take the time. I'm glad to say that the ivy up the side of the house now is now dying off. If I just stick that up there, you can probably see the ivy up the side of the house there, which was where the mice were getting in into the roof at the top. Well, that is now, since I've cut the roots off down there, that's now dying off, and that's going just to, according to plan. I will eventually get up there and pull all that ivy off, and that'll solve the problem. Now, you might remember the scenario we had with the mice getting in the roof and entering upstairs. Well, we eventually, or Sharon, caught 25 mice, and we did sort of think, is it possible that the same mice were coming back? Because we've read on the internet that you've got to really take them 1.5 to 2 miles away, otherwise they will find their way back. So With that in mind, Sharon started to take the mice in the car in the morning, early hours of the morning, and take them like a mile and a half to 2 miles away. And it sort of went quiet after that, so we never really caught any more mice after that. So whether that was the case or what, we don't know, but over the last couple of days, Jimmy said that he still heard a couple of mice up there, so we had to put the traps out again, but nowhere near to the extent what he had in the past. A lot of people have been asking about this BMW there. This is a car that Jimmy, as I said to you, has been working on. It's not my car, and he's still got loads of work. He's having trouble finding the time to do it at the moment. Let me show you it. Again, it's a nice old tool. It's an M-Series BMW. Jimmy's actually painted it now, although the thing still to be done is the hood's still got to be painted, the front bumper, the rear spoiler and boot. Lid has actually got to be painted, and also the rear bumper's got to be painted. But the rest of the car, as you can see, has been painted. It's a bit dirty at the moment. It's got to be cut back still, and that's what Jim is waiting to do. But he's been very busy, obviously, with work. And last weekend, for example, we had we're doing the garden modifications, as you probably know. So lots to do still on this. So if you're watching, I think the chap's name is Adam. It's at my property now, and as I say, Jimmy can only do it when he's got time off. He has to work every other Saturday, and weather permitting gives him the opportunity to do some more work on it. But as you can see, the whole car is painted, and just them bits to do still, and then it's got to be cut back and buffed up and all that. So apart from that, it's looking nice in this deep blue, which it is, a metallic blue. So I've got the old fence paint out now. I'm just going to give this a couple of quick coats. So without further ado, let's put you on a bit of time lapse, get this painted, move on to the next job. All these little tinkering jobs just have to be done. See you in a minute. Here, look who's just turned up. Hello, baby.
Hello.
How are you?
I was going to use that brown on there.
Ah, oh, now you tell me.
Well, I didn't know you was going to do that, did
well,
I?
Well, I didn't know I was going to do it either. What she's saying is, let me show you, I didn't even think of that, wait there. She said she was going to do that brown on that door, which, in hindsight, if I would have looked, would have probably been a good idea, baby.
It still might get done.
Yeah,
well, I've got to do that.
Well, let's call that a preservative coat then, or an undercoat.
Yeah, that's it.
That's what we'll do there. So I've only got a little patch to do. I'll finish that off.
You do that, but you're so clever.
Thank you, baby. I'll tell you what I will have.
Cup of tea.
Nice cup of tea. I'll come in a second. I'll just tell them I'm doing all these little tinkering about jobs. I don't know if you noticed when you drove in, the skip things weren't hanging over.
Yeah, I did notice.
You did notice. Well, that's what I've been doing. I've been having a little tinker. I've started a little video for Retro Hacks. You won't see that. I've told them about the rotovator, but I've not told them what, because that video comes out tomorrow.
Clever man.
Thank you, baby.
You are clever.
You're clever, because you know how to operate the kettle, baby. Go on in. I'll be in a second. Right, I'm just going to finish this little panel off and let that dry, and then she can go over it with the darker stuff. We have got the darker stuff as well. I didn't think. That's what I'm like.
That's what I'm here for.
What?
That's what I'm here for, sort you out.
Hey?
I'm here to sort you out.
Well done, baby. By the way, that caption competition we had the other week, last week, Shell, Bullseye Ant, I think, won it. He still hasn't come forward to claim his prize. We'll give him another week. If not, we'll do a second draw. How about that, Shell? Someone don't want our mug, Sharon.
I can't think what.
Why? It's a great mug.
Yeah, but I've obviously got enough mugs.
Well, I don't think he'd come back and watch the video. But anyway, so you might still get a chance to win that mug if Bullseye Ant doesn't come forward by...
Another 7 days, Bullseye.
Bullseye Ant, yeah, you've got another 7 days. If you don't come and collect it by then, look at all the size of that blinking bee, look. Fantastic, look at that. That's nature, Shell. Look at all these blackberries, Sharon. Look, all this has got to come down in the future. All this has got to be levelled, look. Unbelievable. Right, I'll just finish this off quickly. This ain't going to take a second. Literally, it's only one coat. I was going to give it a couple of coats of this, but now she said that she's going to paint it. It's not worth it. But this is what takes up my day, you see. Little things like this, little jobs like this. And someone said to me on the Butler's Retro Hex channel the other day, Sharon, oh, when are you starting a trotter van? Well, I'm going to start a trotter van. I don't know how many times I've said it. As soon as the Triumph of Claim's out of the way, which is very, near, by the way. She still wants me to get rid of it, folks. I don't know, I might still get rid of it yet, we don't know. But I've done a lot of work to it, as you know, it'd be a shame not to get any use out of it.
3 weeks.
Eh?
You've had it for 3 months,
I can have it for 3 months. I don't want to sell a car in the winter, Sharon. If you're going to sell a car, Sharon, sell it in the summer. So I still might put that out for sale yet, I don't know. But you know, it's got provenance with it, folks, as you probably well know, all the work that I've done to it. So all I've got to do with the Triumph for claim now is bleed the brakes, paint the wheels, put new tyres on it, and paint the hood. The boot lid, sorry. I keep calling it a hood, it's a boot lid. And the only other thing I've got to sort out is the door locks, because them two keys that I had cut, they don't quite fit properly. So I'm going to have to play about with them. So that's all I've got to have done to the Triumph for claim, and that will be coming up again very, very shortly. Once this is out of the way, I've got to get this grass seed down this weekend. And that means still quite a bit of work to do in the garden. And that will be on the Butler's Empire, because someone else asked me, why have you got two channels? Why have you got Retro Restore and Butler's Empire? So I've actually got four channels, but that's another story. Because Butler's Empire is mostly behind the scenes stuff like this. It's like family stuff. You'll see Sharon in a lot of Butler's Empire. The Retro Restore channel is basically for mechanical sort of retro repairs, stuff like that, repairing sort of stuff, or maybe the odd how-to tutorial as I'm doing work. Oh, pardon me, Sharon. How I'm getting over things. But Retro Hacks is restorations, and Butler's Empire is behind the scenes. So you see a lot more banter on the Butler's Empire. That's the reason. And not only that, this is how we earn our money. This is our form of income. We are YouTubers, or creators, what you would call it. What's the matter? I'm doing your trousers when you're walking along, baby. She's going out for a wee, or a waz, as they say up in the Midlands, up in Lincolnshire where I live. So anyway, that's that painted now, albeit not the colour Sharon wanted, but I do see her point, and the great thing about that, it dries in no time. This other stuff, I think, is like a varnish, a coloured varnish, so that will go dark as well, because the front doors are all dark as well. Anyway, that's enough of that. Let's go inside. I'm going to have a cup of tea, clean my brush out, and I'll see you in a minute. Oh, and for those of you who were wondering, yes, I did do it. The back of the door. Can you see all this ivy that's falling off there? Look, up there the leaves are actually dropping now. So we're getting very near to getting rid of that, as I said. Let's go and have a look out the front, see what Sharon's up to. What is she up to out here? What are you doing, baby?
Moving blinking ivy.
Getting rid of more ivy. This is another part of the house where ivy tends to come up and go and try and find its way to the roof as well. So we've got to keep this under control as well. Oh, look what I'm having, a cup of tea, look. Does that mug look familiar to anybody? I must say, baby, you're very hands-on, aren't you? She has a go, didn't you?
Yeah.
A lot of people said, oh, why don't you leave that hole at the front, you know, why knock the fence down, and put a big driveway up there going to a big garage?
No.
I said she wouldn't have it.
No. Why don't you lot mind that? I'm not having a driveway in my garden.
Oh, she's not happy with that, so don't suggest that in the comment section, folks.
No. My God.
What I did suggest once, let me show you, was take down part of this wall here and have a garage gate, and then just build on there a wooden like shed. And I'd love to have that, but again, she won't let me have it. She said I've got enough blinking sheds and stuff.
How many do you need? You're only being one at a time.
Yeah, but I like to work undercover when I'm working on cars, Sharon.
Carpool then?
Yeah, but that's falling down. That's got to be done. That's another job that's got to be done. Our carport here, which we've been up since we've been living here, 20 odd years, plus obviously a lot longer. I mean, that's at the stage now where that really needs replacing as well. So that's the trouble, you see. When you've got a big house, you have all these jobs around the premises or the property that need updating, need modification, need maintenance and stuff like that. And if you're full-time, lucky enough, I work at home, so I do my videos, and that's what I do. So I can bring them to you, and that's part of my income as well. So, you know, it all sort of ties in with what I like doing. I like tinkering about, Shao, don't I, baby? Look at her up this ladder, look.
What's the point of ivy?
Oh, all that dust, baby. Mind my cup of tea?
What's the point of ivy?
What's the point of ivy, Sharon?
A lot of plants have uses.
Yeah, well, it hides stuff. It's a concealer. It's like a camouflage, Sharon. But it grows so blinking fast. It's unbelievable.
Mind you, shown that. Look how
that's I've shown him that, Shell. Yeah, I know, it's all dying. And, Shell, all the leaves are dropping onto the floor at the back there.
Wonderful.
What's that, blinking moth? Little moth there, look. Oh, hello. And also, what you get when you're pulling ivy down, you get all spiders in it as well and stuff like that.
Say that. I haven't given that a thought.
Oh, just letting you know, baby. I know, because I've been working out on the ivy, like round the side of the house there, and I've gone in. I've brushed myself down, obviously, and when I've gone in, I've been sitting on my computer, and I thought, what's that crawling down off? And it's come out of my head. Spiders. I look around, I brush it all off. A bit later on, eh? You have got more hair than me, baby. And I've looked all again on my arm, and there's a blinking spider crawling on my arm. So that's what you get with ivy. Hold on, shall you? Oh, happy days. See what it's doing? That's the blinking dust from that ivy. Anyway, let's let her carry on. I want to go outside. I want to try and dig that Trotter's lawnmower out. It's in a bit of a state, as you know, because I haven't touched it for years. A couple of years, is it, shall? Last year? Hold on, they're going to... And let's see if we can start it, shall we? Let's go out the back. Okie dokie, so here's me old Trotter lawnmower looking pretty sorry for itself. It was pristine when I put it in here, but obviously it's we've had leaky roofs since that time. I've had to fix the roof up there, as you probably remember there. And obviously stuff's been lumbered on top of it. So let's get it out. All right, bear with me. Let's open that door a bit more. Right. The old Trotter lawnmower, eh? Covered in dust, covered in crap. Paintwork's all bleak and marked. Right, let's take it over here. Alright, here we go. And let's do an old start on it. Just to give you a closer look on it, this was absolutely pristine condition when I put it in there. Look at all that, look. Now, again, I haven't touched it, so I don't even know if it's got fuel in it. There's a tiny little bit of fuel in there. I'm probably gonna have to top it up. It's probably evaporated away, so let me get some fuel and we put some fuel in it. Right, okie dokie. So I've got some fresh fuel. Just put that down there. Shouldn't affect the paintwork anyway, because it's been lacquered. And let's get some of that in there. Drop the old go-go juice. So, I mean, initially the carb is going to be filled up with old petrol, old stale fuel. Oh, primer bulb's gone, look. It's still priming, mind you, so hopefully we might be able to get it to start. So, I think I've pushed enough fuel through to the carb. So, it will need a new primer bulb. This is, again, one of them pattern ones. So, get the cloth off of there. Pull that up there and let's see what happens. Unbelievable. Well, there you go. That takes unbelieving, doesn't it? After all that time, neglect, old fuel, a primer bulb which isn't working, this thing fired up second pull. How about that? Well, I think it's worth giving it a good clean up now. I will clean and polish the deck up, get all that back to as it should be. And because we're going to have a bigger lawn area now, we might need two lawnmowers. Someone else suggested that we get a ride on lawnmower, but I'm not too sure about that. This should do the job as well. And we've also got a Briggs & Stratton covered for it to go over the top of it, which was kindly donated by one of our subscribers as well. Anyway, that's enough for this video now. I'm gonna give Sharon a hand now, and I might even make her a cup of tea. So don't forget, if you do like our channel, click the subscribe button down there, ring that little notification bell next to the subscribe button, and set your preferences to all. That way you'll get notified every time we upload a video. Check out my Retro Restore channel coming up this week, and you'll see what happened with that cultivator, tiller, whatever you want to call it, that we had problems with in the previous video. Anyway, thanks very much. I'll see you in the next video, and until then, bye for now. How about that?